Hi guys, Greg here.
Greg here, John here.
We're gonna watch the trailer for Beauty and the Beast.
Oh,
the
boy.
Second trailer. I am so stoked for this. I have never been more excited for a film out of the DCEU more than now.
I think David Ayer's really got this in the back.
That's beautiful.
My dear Belle.
She looks just like Belle.
So ahead of your time. This is a small village. You are the most gorgeous thing I've ever seen. Nobody is small-minded as well. But small also means safe.
Oh, scary music.
Krampus.
Whoa.
He's come for my father.
He's a thief.
Come into the light. Said that.
Hello.
You can talk.
Hello, horse. It's all he ever does.
How lovely to make your acquaintance.
Want to see me do a trick? What happens when the last petal falls?
She wasn't that amused by the trick.
The master remains a beast forever. And we become antiques. What did you do to it?
Nothing.
Get out of here. Go!
Nipple chill. I can feel it, yeah.
If
oh,
she's the one who'll break the spell, you must finally learn to love.
Have you really read every one of these books?
No. Some of them are in Greek.
True as it can be.
You're funny.
Sky. Sky.
Production design.
Yeah. Production value, too.
Well, if that doesn't make you want to check this out even for a little bit, I don't know what will.
Yeah, I gotta say, that's an all-out trailer right there.
It's almost exactly like the cartoon. It's crazy.
Yeah.
I saw the cartoon a few times when I was younger. It's been probably over a decade since I've seen the film. What's but I'm that? Like, I've seen all these scenes before.
Well, yeah, like I was flashing back. I was like, yeah. I can see the color and the strokes and all that. Looks like finally, I didn't see, what was the one they did before? Cinderella? Kenneth Branagh? I didn't see that, and I heard good things. But like, of all of these fairy tale revival, like live action movies lately, this one, at least from this trailer, does seem like we're just going to transcribe that exact sweeping feeling to live action.
It looks great.
Pretty impressive.
It looks beautiful. I'm not going to necessarily go for what different thing are they going to do with Beauty and the Beast. I'm going to go with exactly what they want me to go up with, which is I want to see a live version of the cartoon. Like, that's pretty much what I'm going for. But the production design, and like you said, the production value, like every bit of the costumes and everything just looks so fantastic. Yeah. The visual effects don't look bad either. I mean, it's like there's only so far you can go with making visual effects look super real. But for the most part, I'm like, this doesn't look distractingly, like, awful in any capacity. I mean, some moments were cut weird. Like,
yeah, there are moments where I came out of it and I was like, I don't know. But, you know, like, the majority of this, especially when they go to that montage at the end, they go out of their way to show you, like, here's all the, like, you know, dancing and production and numbers you're going to see that we can't really just, like, show you all over the trailer. It looks like they really put everything into this.
Oh, totally. You know? And my only concern when I saw the trailer was, how am I going to feel about Gaston? It was Luke Evans. Because when I saw them in the previous clips, I'm like, yeah, I can't see, and from knowing Luke Evans' roles before, I'm like, I just can't see him doing this role. He's such a serious actor. But seeing the little bit we got here, I was like, he's going to be the highlight.
He looks like James Marsden was in the live action.
Enchanted?
That? Enchanted, yeah. Like, I feel like that's what this could be for him. Because, he looks really funny as Gaston. And even just the way that they bothered to make him look stylized like the cartoon, like the pompadour thing and all that.
Yeah. Someone might argue, like, you know, if I wanted to see the animated movie, I'll watch the animated movie. But because of this, of all the designs in this film, it's like a retelling in its own live animation in a way, you know?
Yeah.
Because there's still so much to tune in for. Yeah, it's not a cartoon, but there's a lot of visual flair in here that makes it its own kind of animation. So it's I don't see this being like an unnecessary thing. Well, it's not necessary, but I don't see myself like being a hater going in there like, this is exactly like a cartoon. They didn't do anything different, you know?
Well, it seems like they really put the effort into it.
Yeah.
You know? Like, that's what this communicates to me. It's like, we don't necessarily need to do this again, but I like the looks of it. I don't know if this is based on any fact, but I get the sense that we're more embracing of like big production musicals again.
Oh, totally.
And like, Hamilton is like so huge and just like everybody knows about it. And then, you know, we've had a lot of Disney's making a lot of their like classic musicals again. Yeah, I mean, maybe this is a return to big number musicals and then La La Land and stuff, you know.
That sounds great. I mean, this guy worked on the script for Dreamgirls and he directed Dreamgirls. He worked on the script for Chicago.
Okay.
So this guy knows how to put music. And he did Twilight Breaking Dawn.
Oh, hell yeah. Teen romance.
That right there, if that doesn't solidify faith, I don't know what will.
I mean, like, on paper, that's the right blend of ideas, yeah. I guess. Romantic, slightly horror fantasy, and then big production musical, you know.
Yeah, this looks epic. I'm excited for it. I'm excited for exactly what I feel like they're gonna deliver to us.
Yeah. I would be very surprised if this went wrong. And from hearing, you know, I heard Cinderella was great, so I...
Yeah, I've actually heard early reports that this film's pretty good, too.
I'm excited.
I mean, I've heard that Emma Watson is alright, but, you know, she's surrounded by characters that are way more fascinating than Belle. She's like the normal straight girl.
Oh,
okay. Heterosexual girl. She's like, she's
cis heterosexual.
Yeah, you got a beast in there. You got like a talking candle. Yeah, you got guests on. There's so many more interesting characters
whose head you're gonna drink out of.
Yeah, exactly.
While you hold up a conversation.
All right, guys, are you excited for Beauty and the Beast? Comments in the comment boxes.
Comment below. Let me know. Awesome tacular.
Subscribe to the Real Rejects, please. Wow.
Sorry.
John is Reasons to Jerry on Instagram and Twitter. He's a social media manager at Bloomhouse and The Real Rejects. We'll give a shout out to one of our top spenders in the last 30 days on You Now.
Oh boy.
Strawberry Lemon 2348. Dude, I gotta tell you, like, I've tasted many things that taste like a strawberry lemon. But we just did a video for Beauty and the Beast, so I won't say what it is. Oh, there's a cruise ship outside with some seamen on there. The seamen.
Men of the sea.
The men of the sea might taste like strawberry lemons, you know?